Hello guys, welcome back to a Two Ordinary Guys video. This video is about the ambulance service and being a paramedic. I've got a couple of things I want to cover in this video, and hopefully this is beneficial to you guys and helps be a bit informational. You might know it all, you might not. If it helps, give it as a like and, you know, subscribe, because this is going to be like an ongoing thing now. I'm going to make this quite like a series maybe. Like, I'm going to take you guys through my journey to the ambulance service. And obviously feedback to what my knowledge. I've got written down as some things I want to cover. So I'm going to explain what a paramedic does. So a bit about being a paramedic and what they do to the community, be a bit informational. The positive and negatives of the job. Now, there is a lot of positives, but also there's some negatives. So we need to take them into consideration before you decide if it is the career you want to go through. And then I'm going to explain a little bit of why I want to be a paramedic and the reason about it. So what made me want to become a paramedic? Obviously, I'm so adamant, oh yeah, this is what I want to do. But I'm going to explain to you why I want to be a paramedic. And in the comments, put if you feel like you want to, and you obviously you want to express that. I'd like to know why you guys want to be a paramedic. Obviously, I'd like to know everyone's opinion on this. And if I get any of the information wrong, please just knock it down in the comments, or if you want to put any information down, knock it in the comments. But yeah, anyway, I'll see you guys in a bit. This part of the video, guys, is about what a paramedic does. Now, I've took a bit off the internet, and I'm going to feed it back to you guys. If you don't agree with it, put it down in the comments, like I said. But I do think this is a good description on what a paramedic does. So it says, paramedics care for the sick or injured in an emergency medical setting. People's lives often depend on the paramedics' quick reactions and competent care. So obviously you're relying on that individual to make the correct decision for you. When you need a paramedic, you are in need. You don't call, well, people, I say that. When you call the ambulance, you are in need of their services, but not always. You know, sometimes you get hoax calls. Sometimes I might even need the ambulance, and that's a big ongoing problem, guys, at the moment. They respond to emergency calls, perform medical services, and transport patients to the medical facilities. Now, I want to add on to that a little bit, because I feel as though people think being a paramedic, you're all seeing blood and everything. It's not all like that, guys. You might be taking the elderly to a doctor's appointment, you know, or going to a care home because an elderly resident has had a fall and banged their head. And that can be a very serious thing to happen to someone, guys. When they're old and a head injury, it can be quite serious. So that's, people might not see that as serious, but it is. I know that because I work in a care home at the moment, if you don't know that. So that was what a paramedic does. In the next section, I'm going to expand on it. And I'm going to explain the pros and the cons. So the positive and the negatives. And I'm going to feed it back. Right, so we've spoken on the last part about what I feel a paramedic is. And what they do. Now, I'm obviously, like I've said before, I'm going to speak about the positives and the negatives of the job. And put me in perspective on my opinion. Obviously, because I haven't been in the ambulance service before, I'm training to be a paramedic at the moment. I don't actually know what it's like to be in the ambulance service, but this is what I feel and what I can imagine it from. So, I feel the first, I've written down here just beforehand. I've written the positives are saving a life, relationships with the colleagues. I'll explain that in a moment. And another thing is, you're trusted to save a life. I'll obviously speak about that in a moment. The cons of the job, obviously, a lot of paperwork. On the internet, I can Google it early, about an hour ago, and people are saying that the pay. So I'm going to be speaking about the salary of a paramedic, and also being in a paramedic as well, it causes a lot of stress. Now, I'll go on to the positives first. So, saving a life, obviously, is a cliche. everyone wants to save a life. I would do, well, not everyone, but when you go into the ambulance service, that's the main thing you want to do, save a life. That's what I want to go into. And I can imagine saving a life for anyone out there would be an amazing thing. Amazing thing to say to your family, to your friends, that I've saved a life. I think that'd be absolutely amazing. I can imagine that when you go to, I don't know, an elderly man that's in need of being resuscitated, he's not breathing, he's maybe had a cardiac arrest. You start CPR, doesn't work, trying, and finally on that cardiac monitor, you get a heartbeat. That feeling for me would be absolutely amazing for me. So I think that saving life would be obviously the cliche, that's one positive of the job. Relationships with your colleagues, I feel as though in the ambulance service you build a very good relationship. This is because I've been speaking to a lot of range of West Midlands Ambulance Service staff. They come into my care home. When you're in the ambulance service, obviously you're working with, you might be working with range people, but there's normally some people that you work with on a regular basis. So then you start to, I don't know, get to know them sort of thing. So you know their strengths and weaknesses. And obviously you, before they're even thinking of what they're already thinking, you already know, if you get what I mean. So you can sort of be thinking before they even think. So you can know their strengths and they know your strengths. And I feel as though that would make you provide care on a different level. Because obviously you know each other, you know what you do best, you know is what triggers some stress, which we're going to speak about in the negative part of the job. The other part about is, what was it, you're trusted to save a life. Now, when obviously I'm training to do CPR now, and obviously to resuscitate and do the basic first aid, but when you go into that, to the house or wherever you go into, wherever an accident has happened, you go into that job and that person that's needing your support is trusting all their will for you to provide the amazing care, to help them, to support them. They're trusting you, their family, their friends, everyone's trusting you to provide that care for them. And I feel as though that, for me, would be amazing, because obviously people look at you and think, yeah, I trust him. I would honestly trust him. Obviously, they don't really have any choice in it. So they're giving all their trust into you as a person to make them better. I feel that'd be amazing, because that's what I set out to do. I would like to be trusted on saving a life. I know it's a lot of pressure, but as you go along, you do learn and pick up the pressure, and you do learn from the things you do. Now, paperwork, guys, on the negative side, there is a lot of paperwork. Now, if you didn't know before, I think this should be taken into consideration when you go into the ambulance service. This is what, I think his name was Steve, he told me, he works in West Midlands Ambulance Service. He said, look, Kyle, he says, it's not all blood and guts. There's a lot of paperwork in this job, and you have to put up with it. He said, it's boring, it can be boring, but you just need to stick to it. He says, you have to write statements, handovers, you know, reports. There's a lot of things, you know, medical reports, assessing all the risks and everything. There's always, but it's done on a computer now, so it's not all paperwork, but there's still a lot of work that goes into it. Now, if you didn't know that before, I think that's a big thing to take into consideration. There's a lot of paperwork, so your English skills and your math skills are needed in this job before you even start. Now, salary. I think it's about 21,900 to about 29,000, if I'm mistaken. That's in the UK. That's 21,900 to 29,000. That's if you work up. Obviously, you sort of fit in between that thing. But you can actually work up to, I think it's around 35,000 if you do extra training, like in the trauma section, in the trauma area. You move up to band 6, I believe, and you earn more money. Now, 35,000 is quite a lot of money for some people, but 21,000 isn't really that much when you think about it for the job you do. And you, when you're a paramedic, there's a lot of things that you need and skills you need to be a paramedic, and 21,000 doesn't really represent that, I don't think. So that is a big consideration if you want to go into the ambulance service, guys. You have to put the work in order for your pocket to feel it. I think that's a big situation. And the last one is stress. Now, every person in the ambulance, service, the paramedics, they're different. Stress is triggered in different ways. Obviously, if your wife had a miscarriage, when you're going to deliver a baby and they have a miscarriage, that would trigger stress for you because obviously it's personal to you and it might trigger some stress. Obviously, if one of your loved ones hung themselves and you go to a hanging, that would cause stress for you. I feel as though stress for me would be obviously mental health and suicide because obviously my stepdad committed suicide. So if I went to a job where someone's committed suicide, I think that would cause a little bit of stress for me. Now, with that stress comes a supportive family and friends because you need to talk about that stress to your family and friends as it's just going to build up and build up and build up. And if it does that, then working in the ambulance service is going to be a very, very, very horrible time for you because it's going to affect you and it's going to cause you a number of mental health problems yourself. So if the most important thing is talking to someone about your problems and addressing them as a problem as well, like actually admitting it's a problem. So that's some positives and some negatives of the job. But yeah, I've sort of said what caused me stress as well in the stress. But apart from that, I'm going to move on now to why I want to be a paramedic and how to get there. Okay? Hello, guys. This part is a bit about why I want to become a paramedic and also what options there is if you guys want to become a paramedic. The reason why I want to become a paramedic, guys, is when I was about 9 years old, I was walking to the local shop and I witnessed a road traffic collision. A motorbike and a car collided on this corner where I used to live, and this guy shot off his motorbike. Went about 10 meters down the road. Obviously, someone called the emergency services. Paramedics and the police turned up. The guy was the one on the motorbike was made was pronounced dead on the scene, and all I can remember was seeing lots of blood. Obviously, when I seen all these emergency services working together from a young age, I was like, I really envied it. And I looked up at the emergency services and done a lot of research on them when I was obviously. And then we was in school, and everyone was all going round. I can remember this. And the teacher said to a couple of my friends, "Oh, what do you want to do? They want to be an engineer, mechanic." And they said to me, "Well, what do you want to do, Kyle?" I said, "I want to become a paramedic." And the entire class laughed at me. And then I was like, "Well, why can't I become a paramedic?" So that's what made me want to, because I like to prove people wrong as well. Now, the other reason why I want to become a paramedic, guys, is saving lives. Obviously, what I mentioned on the positive effects of the job, saving a life for me is what I set out to do. I like to give back to the community as well. Obviously, I work in a care home. I'm always giving back to my residents. I try and give the best care that I can, try and make their lives better. Now, I feel as though being a paramedic, I can do that as well. That obviously, I like to leave work knowing that I've made a difference to someone's life, and I think that's a huge aspect of why I want to become a paramedic as well. Along with that, I feel as though it's a job for life. I think, you know, when you become a paramedic, you don't think, "Oh, I'm going to stay in here for 5, 6 years." It's a job for 40, 50 years until you retire, really. It's a job that's always different. Like an office job, you go into work, you do the same things over and over again. As soon as you're in the ambulance and you get that call, it could be anything. It could be absolutely anything. And I feel as though I like the sort of thing that is different on every single shift. Every single shift is not the same. I've been speaking to a range of ambulance staff that come to my care home, part of West Midlands Ambulance Service, and they've been giving me a lot of information. But yeah, there's two options to become a paramedic. There is the university route, so you can apply to do paramedic science. That takes You can either do 2 year or a 3 year course. Now, I might be wrong, but I think they may be stopping the 2 year course. I'm not quite sure, but there's a 2 year course which After 2 year course is completed, you're registered with the HCPC, and obviously then you can apply to the ambulance services because you're registered, and then you can work up from there. The 3 year course you can do either online, or you can obviously stay and study and do the extra year in university, and obviously then you get all the hands-on work. You don't get the hands-on work, sorry. You're obviously in study, doing all the nitty-gritty paperwork. The other option is applying to the ambulance firm provision, say, for example, West Midlands Ambulance Service, and them teaching you the ways. But to do this, I think you need a manual driving licence, and I think you might have to have applied for your C1 provisional by the time you apply. And obviously you have to go for an interview. There's a selection process, all these like fitness tests, a highway code test. So there's a lot of things you have to do in that, in the ambulance service route if you want to go that way. My personal opinion, I'm not quite sure. I'm quite stuck in the middle here because I can go to university and you can do all the paperwork and obviously then you get registered. But it's easier said than done, guys, to go to university. The reason why, if you watch my other videos, there was a couple of interviews that I went to Coventry and Worcester. There was 1,000 applicants for Coventry, and I think only 80 places got given. Now, if you think of it, 1,000 people narrowed down to 80. It's a bit of a difference, you know what I mean? And they do look for, you know, high standards. It's not just short standard, it's very, very high standard to get into the ambulance service. And it's becoming harder and harder, I feel. But I don't know, but I would apply to the ambulance service provision, West Midlands Ambulance Service, when I do get my licence. That's what I'm setting out to do. I'm going to try and get my licence. Obviously, also, to get into university, you have needed to do, for example, I'm doing level 3 extended diploma in health and social care. That would get me in, because it's BTEC level 3. Another thing, you can do an access course, or you can do, obviously, your A-levels. I think you need to be equivalent to 3 A-levels to get into the course. And obviously, you need your standard English, maths and science. That will get you onto the course, and I believe that it can get you into the ambulance service as well. It gets you into both routes. So it's really worth doing. But yeah, that's why I wanted to come into the ambulance service, and also the different options, different routes. So university, paramedic science, or you can actually apply to the ambulance firm, West Midlands Ambulance Service, or any ambulance service you want to apply to, and you could actually be a student paramedic with that ambulance service, and then they teach you how to do your job through that way. Obviously, but there's a lot of requirements in that job. A lot of requirements to get into the service on that way. It's just whatever you feel you're comfortable with, and obviously which ones you meet. Obviously, because I haven't got my license, so I'll move more onto the university side of it. It's just what you guys are comfortable with and what you guys meet. But yeah, that's why I want to be a paramedic. I've explained a bit about what the paramedics do, the ambulance service, and I've given the positive and negatives of being a paramedic. I hope this video was beneficial to you guys, and if you would like another one, smash the like button. Hopefully it gets 10 likes, that'd be amazing. I'll do another video. The next video I'll probably be doing is, I've got an announcement to make. I'll announce that in the next video. But yeah, exciting news, guys. I'll see you guys later. It's Two Ordinary Guys, Kyle here. Peace out.